Hello! How is everyone doing? I hope super well. I'm going to assume we are. Happy 2020. We've made it into a new year. Well, today I have had quite a long, busy day that I'm going to share some exciting updates with you guys about. But what has happened is I have now completed my second round of chemotherapy and will be starting my third round of chemotherapy here shortly. But finishing up the second one and coming back from my brother's wedding. That's why I was in Mexico. So I have a little bit of a light tan, if you can't tell. It's not that noticeable. But coming back from that, I had to complete my MRI to see an update on how it's been going doing these chemo treatments. So, like I said, I completed round two. And if I can give you quick an update on how that's been going, just as a reminder. I've been feeling super nauseous, where I have felt nauseous brushing my teeth and hardly keeping, down food, not being able to eat. So real nausea, not throwing up, but getting really, really, really close. I was super fatigued, but I would take it one step further and say even lethargic, where I was having to sit. And honestly, even as a millennial myself, using screens a lot, not even being able to look at screens, like TV, computer, cell phone, just feeling fatigued and lethargic and awful. I keep using awful and miserable as a word because that is how I felt post chemo. And I have that to look forward to again here, but I'll get to that when I get to that. So, what was I looking forward to today? What is the progress of my brain after having such a miserable chemo experience? So I always want a printout to show you how things went. So I asked for two printouts, and I actually had to take them on my phone, so they might not be as easy to see and explain. But let me do my darndest here. So this is four images. One of them is, you can't even tell because it is a colorful photo. Again, I took pictures with my cell phone and then printed them off so I could look at them a little bit more closely. So I'm going to jump to the one that actually has more relevancy. So first and foremost, good update. Great update. And the way to make it sound the easiest and smoothest is if we looked at my very first photo, which I should have grabbed to share with you guys. But to now, there is that circle. This is where the tumor was. And when I say was, it was filled with the full tumor. But remember, when I did my Mayo surgery, they removed 80% of it. So it's hardly there. So I say was because it's empty in this actual circle in my brain. Now, in this image below, you can't tell, but normally underneath my actual circle where they removed is still some tumor. So remember, my tumor was the size of a baseball, but it wasn't like perfectly circular. There's like a tiny bit of tumor underneath this open circle that we are keeping our eye on because it sits on my speech portion of my brain. And believe it or not, whether you like it or not, you're watching the video for a reason. I am a big talker. Keeping my voice is so important and precious that he did not operate on that part of my head because he can't. It's too dangerous to titch with, right? And there's a tumor there that could keep growing, could come back, also can be healed in Jesus' name. But what we did see in this scan that is the good news is that there is no blood infusing in that area more intensively. So what could happen is we could see there be a larger source of blood, and what that would mean is that it's attacking the tumor, and when I say attacking, it is trying to grow, or it is like hyped up because it is growing, those types of things. So what we know is what the chemo is doing to what I have currently, or what I don't have currently, is what I should say, is great news, and we're going to continue moving forward with that, and we're not seeing regrowth or new growth of what is there currently. So it sounds like a really confusing update, but it is a fantastic update. And with me feeling miserable, I'm gonna have to feel miserable for another 2 months at least before we find out more information to know that I'm gonna be continuing to heal, continuing to feel good, hopefully getting more days like the past few days, like in Mexico, right? I mean, sunshine, water, you're going to feel good after that, no matter what. So that's what's coming next. That's what happened at the MRI, and such great news. We have to celebrate that with a congrats or a yay, Nicole, because we see these good results ultimately. Now, what's coming next, you guys, just as a reminder for you all, is the Bend It for Bates benefit. That, remember, it was originally on January 16th, which would have been next weekend, which would be confusing for everyone and harder to do because it actually would have been a Thursday. So it would have been next week, middle of the week, and hard during work hours. It was at 5 o'clock. Now we've moved it to January 25th, which is a Saturday, the following week. And it, to be honest, will be post-chemo treatment, so I could feel miserable. So hopefully not. That's the goal, is to not be feeling awful. But remember, it is also now in a more local, more convenient location. It's in Woodbury. It is located at the Woodbury Lifetime. You do not need to be a member in order to get in. You don't have to pay for anything. So if you bought tickets beforehand, you got reimbursed. Know that you can come for free to the event, but it is a benefit event. So we will have some silent auctions going on. And also the Strong Storm Co. bracelet company will be there selling their bracelets as well. So there'll be items that you can purchase, and that money will go towards me and Davis. And then this other gal who we are representing or having there to be represented as well. She's unfortunately passed, but her family is still suffering the medical consequences, the bills that come with that whole thing in their life, right? That loss, which is tragic and unfortunate to even hear about, right? So the Woodbury Lifetime, Bend It for Bates on the 25th for free. Mike Bjornson is also a host of this event, of this benefit, on top of Lexi and Jennifer and Blair, who put the event on to begin with, or the benefit on to begin with. But Mike was one of my, he was my personal trainer. He trained me to win my bodybuilding pro card that I got back in 2016, I believe is when I won it. Around that time frame. It's been so much has happened since. My brain's a little tired as well. So he is hosting with those gals, Jen, Lexi, and Blair. And then his wife is actually phenomenal. I haven't met her yet, but I've only watched her be awesome via social media. She is going to be teaching two fitness classes at the a benefit. So right away, I believe at 9 and at 10. So if you want to come and get in a workout, you don't have to be a workout expert. You don't have to be in shape. You don't have to overthink it because she's got you. And I love movement. I love exercise. And they're hosting that. They're hosting, I believe, nutrition resources or class as well. And again, all of the vendors will be there. A lot of socialization will be happening. Believe it with me, I will love to talk to everyone. But that's what the benefit is. So I really hope that you can make it. If you are somebody who sells a service and you're willing to put it in a basket for the donation, please feel free to contact me via either text messaging if you have it, calling. You can email me. Otherwise, you can reach out via social media, tag the people you know that could get involved in that as well if you have those people in your life. Otherwise, great news today, you guys. I'm excited to share this update with you all, and I will keep you updated moving forward. Please know that I have my chemo medication starting next week, and I could feel awful. So please pray for me if you're willing to pray. Send me love, send me support, send me good vibes if you're willing to do that as well. Otherwise, have a great rest of your day, and I'll keep you in the loop with updates.